I feel like I've had a pretty productive day today. I still haven't edited a video like I wanted to do, and I haven't worked on my Diamond Art Club like I wanted to work on, but I felt like working on some more of the Jaguar and listening to another Mystery Theater with you since I've got so much done around the house. And this way I know I'm going to have the best chance possible to sit here for the full 40 minutes while working on this. So, we are going to work on another piece of this while listening to some more Mystery Theater. Now, let's see which episode we are going to be listening to and who gave it to us. We just listened to episode 972 from Candace the Bunless Wonder, and that was quite an interesting one. What was it called? The Golden Lady? Something very similar to that, if not that. The Golden Girl is what it was. All right. Next up is Mary Robert with episode 74. I think this is the first time we've been down to a two-digit number. The last one was the first time we were at a three-digit number, too, but it was a high three-digit. You tell people to give you a number between 1,000, or between 1 and 1,400, and apparently people tend to aim high. At least that's what I've noticed with a lot of you guys. Maybe I'm wrong, because there's also a 66 in here and a 55, but I feel like the majority of the people aimed high. So we are on 74. 74. Only the dead remember. Ooh, that sounds like it could be an interesting episode. Alright, so this episode we are listening to is episode 74, and the number was said by Mary Robert. And the episode is called Only the Dead Remember, which to me the title sounds very appealing. So let's get into this. Again, I am going to go ahead and work on the V's, I do believe. So I will need to angle you guys down a bit more. And I'm going to just get all of the V's and J's done and then go back up to the missing letters. Up there. So, we are going to start the show now. Thank you.
The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents...
And the door crinkle, or crackle, or whatever you call that. Creak. There, creak. The door creak. Doom, doom. Come in.
Come in. I'm E.G. Marshall. Welcome to the sounds of suspense. Justice, the noblest creation and the highest ideal of man. The foundation of all religion and the cornerstone of every law. Justice, the birthright of every human being on the face of the earth. Justice, we're brought up to believe in it, to expect it. But what about those people who suddenly discover that for them, there isn't any justice?
You just don't go around killing people, Eddie. But there are people who have to be killed.
The war's over. It's been over for a long time.
No, it isn't. Not for me.
Eddie, you're home now. Don't you understand? What could we tell the police?
The truth. We have no evidence. That's why we have to hunt them down and kill them ourselves, so that justice can be done.
We can only have justice through the law.
Okay. Tell me. Will the law give us justice?
I just told you we have no evidence.
Okay. No justice from the law. So where and to whom do we go for justice?
I definitely have some thoughts on this, but I am not interested in sharing them.
Will there be any justice?
Our mystery drama, Only the Dead Remember, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars... For a long time, ever since he came home from one of our wars, Eddie Benson has been looking for someone. Those vital years of his life that might have been invested in a career, devoted to a family, have instead been devoured by an all-consuming search as Eddie Benson roamed the length and breadth of America, supporting himself by his nimble and sensitive fingers, playing the piano, in grimy saloons, in sophisticated night spots, but always looking, always listening, ever alert for a clue that could lead to his quarry. Well, now, tonight, suddenly the manhunt will come to an end in a cocktail lounge in a northwestern city just a few minutes before midnight. Odd how a search so intense could be climaxed by a discovery so casual. How so serious and deadly a crusade can be capped with a laugh. That laugh. Eddie Benson hasn't heard that laugh in years. That laugh. He would recognize it anywhere. It could only belong to one person. And now Eddie's fingers slide softly and swiftly over the keyboard and find a melody. A pretty little melody that has a special meaning for certain people. Especially for that comfortable-looking man at the corner table. The man with that laugh.
So I said to her, "My dear, if I were to get married again, it would be the triumph of hope over experience."
Yeah. Yes, sir, Mr. Jackson. That's a good one, all right. What's
the
matter, Mr. Jackson? The matter? You okay? You've got a funny look on your face all of a sudden.
Hey, Millie.
You didn't get sick or something?
Who's that? Who's that playing the piano tonight?
Oh, some guy filling in for Woody. You know
him? No. For a minute, though, I thought he may have looked familiar. That's just my imagination. Millie?
What is it, Mr. Jackson?
Ask him if he'll,
You got a request, Mr. Jackson?
Yeah, I have. Ask him to quit playing that song.
You don't like it? It's kind of a catchy tune.
Just give him this. Tell him to play something else.
Eddie.
You got a request.
Request in reverse. A customer says to take this $10 and quit playing what you're playing now.
What's this character's name?
Jackson. R.J. Jackson.
I see. R.J. Jackson. Does he, live around here?
No. Up on the hill. All kinds of money.
Figures.
Huh?
Funny, Millie. How it ends. Where it ends. Times I thought it would never end. All these years, it kind of took over, you know. It became a way of life.
Look, I wish I knew what you were talking about.
No, you don't, Millie. I think I'll split.
You mean walk out? You can't just walk out on.
How'd you like to make $10?
All depends.
You keep the 10 spot, and as soon as I'm out of here, you go up to him, good old R.J. Jackson, see, and you say to him, "Mother Hennessy's chickens are coming home to roost."
You're kidding.
Say it. You're $10 ahead.
Yeah, but you can't just quit in the middle of playing.
Remember the chickens, Millie. See you around.
Yeah. Oh, boy. The more I get to know musicians. Now, how'd that go? Mother Hennessy's chickens. Mr. Jackson, Mr. Jackson, the piano player, he wanted me to tell you something.
Yeah? A minute's thanks. That's the easiest $10 he ever made.
Well, What he wanted to tell you was...
Yeah? Well?
Well, he said, let's see. Mother Hennessy's chickens are coming home to roost.
Laughing stops.
What's that?
I'm sure that's what he said. Mother Hennessy's chickens are...
No. No.
Mr. Jackson. Hey, somebody. Give me a hand, quick. He's fainted.
Something definitely happened wrong if he's that afraid of that call.
Oh. What? Oh, no way. All right. I'm up. Yeah. Hello?
Tom? Tom Wilson?
Yeah, that's Tom Wilson. You know what time it is? It happens...
I got a message for you, Tom. Mother Hennessy's chickens are coming home to roost.
What? What did you say? Who is this? Hello? Hello?
Wow.
Hello?
Is Bill Traynor at home?
No, but I expect him. Who's calling?
Is this his wife?
Yes, I'm Liz Traynor.
Will you take a message?
Well, of course.
Tell him... Mother Hennessy's chickens are coming home to roost.
Yes?
That's all.
Nope.
You're joking. Hello? Hello?
Oh, wow. Came in just a second.
Oh, Bill. You know, you just missed a phone call.
Oh, never mind that. What'd the doctor say?
Oh, things are just fine. He'll be born on schedule.
You mean you won't take a girl?
Darling, I'll take whatever we can get.
I can't believe it, honey. After all this time, everything but everything is going our way. You know, Tom
tells him that line.
Oh, Bill. Oh, I'm so happy.
We're going to be rich, honey. We're going to own a business, and we're going to be parents. What were you saying about a phone call?
Oh, well, a man just called. Very mysterious. Hmm? He said to tell you that, Mother Hennessy's chickens are coming home to roost.
He said what?
Well, that's what he said. He hung up.
Yep.
Can it mean anything?
Oh, no, nothing at all. Just forget it.
What about dinner? Bill, dinner?
Did the man say anything else?
Bill, you're so pale.
Honey, believe me, this is really nothing that should concern you.
The key is the name Hennessy.
Where should we go to dinner?
Darling, you're trying to distract me. Hennessy, we don't know any Hennessy.
Look, honey, I've just been going at a very fast pace, and...
Hennessy's chickens, that combination is familiar.
Darling, I'm really very hungry.
I've got it. Your old army outfit is holding a reunion.
What do you know about my old army outfit?
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all, except you and Tom Wilson were in it together. You were in Korea. You were prisoners, and you refused to talk about it, even to me.
Why do you say we're having a reunion?
Hennessy, what? Last year when we moved into this house, I was putting a lot of your old stuff away. There was an army picture of you and Tom Wilson. Well, you must have been all of 18, and two other young soldiers. In the middle, an older man, a sergeant. And underneath it, you had written, Mother Hennessy's chickens. It just clicked in my mind. That sergeant, that older man.
He was all of 26.
Well, his name was Hennessy, wasn't it?
Yes.
And he looked after all of you like a mother hen.
Yes.
And now you're having a reunion. Oh, Bill. What a wonderful person, that Sergeant Hennessy. How I want to meet him.
No, you can't.
Why?
He's dead.
Oh. Was he killed in the war?
In the prison camp.
Bill, that music, that piano.
Hmm?
Don't you hear it? It's coming from the living room. Someone's playing the piano. I didn't hear anyone ring the bell. Well, let's go see.
No.
But someone's in the apartment.
Liz, stay here.
Bill.
I want you to stay in the bedroom.
But why?
Liz, in all the years we've been married, I never asked you to do anything just because I said so. But I'm asking you now, please.
All right, Bill.
Just for a while.
Mm-hmm.
Hello, Eddie.
Front door was open. I just walked in.
Well, you're welcome, Eddie. Been a long time.
A lifetime. Nice layout.
Yeah. I've done well.
I'm sure you deserve it.
I went to school on the GI Bill, became an engineer.
I always said you had the stuff, Billy.
I'm going to own a good-sized electronics company.
That's nice.
Our old buddy Tom, Tom Wilson, remember him?
Who could ever forget Tom?
Well, he's drawing up the contract. He became a lawyer. What about yourself, Eddie?
Me?
Yeah, a fellow with your talent, the way you could write songs like this one for Hennessy. We all figured we'd hear you doing Broadway musicals, coming up with top hits.
Well, I've been too busy.
Doing what?
Looking for somebody. Looking for an old friend of ours.
Oh, like that was the guy that tortured
Bill?
Him?
I had a phone call. The craziest phone call.
Hello, Tommy.
Eddie. Hey, Eddie Benson. It could only have been you. Where you been hiding?
Tom? Billy? I got the greatest news in the world. I found him.
Hmm?
I finally found him.
You finally found who?
The needle in the haystack. One grain of sand on the beach. It was such a long time. It was such a long search.
Eddie, who did you find?
Who do you think? Myers.
Myers? R.J. Myers?
He doesn't call himself Myers anymore, but it's still R.J. Robert Joseph. Or, as Hennessy said, our own little Bobby Joe.
That's incredible.
Except he's not so little anymore. He's a very portly gentleman these days.
You say you found him?
I found him.
What did you say to him, Eddie?
Nothing.
Well, how could you just say nothing?
Tom, you, Billy, and I, we've got nothing to say to Bobby Joe. I just made sure of where we could find him, and I came here to pick up you two guys.
Eddie.
I have a 45. What do you guys want to use?
Eddie, what are you saying?
I'm saying if we leave now, we can fly to where he is in less than 3 hours and kill him before midnight.
I'm guessing he might have been one of the ones that tortured them or betrayed them.
Kill. Into the pleasant, well-ordered, comfortable world of Bill Traynor and Tom Wilson, there suddenly intrudes a strange, terrifying, and ugly word. It's not a word of this world. It's a word that belongs to another world, a world of pain and horror, a world that they thought was... When they were 19 years old, Eddie Benson, Bill Traynor, and Tom Wilson suffered and starved and froze in a prison camp in North Korea. Now it's a lifetime later, and to Tom and Bill, Korea is barely a dream.
Barely a nightmare.
But Eddie Benson is still stuck deep in the nightmare, still determined to carry out a deadly promise they made to each other long ago.
I thought you two guys would be glad to see me. Now. Now we can keep our promise.
Secret.
What
revenge.
Promise?
Tom, you're kidding, aren't you? Bill, you remember the promise the three of us made? Well, do you?
Yes.
It was more than a promise.
Eddie.
It was an oath.
Look, Eddie.
No, you look, Tom. You look back at a mound of dirt in that prison camp in Korea. You look back and see three guys were kneeling next to that mound of dirt because it's Hennessy's grave. Look back and hear us swear never to rest, never to stop, never to know a moment's peace until we kill Robert Joseph Myers.
Eddie, how could we just kill him?
How? Simple. Blow his brains out.
You live in another world, whether you realize it or not. Now, you just don't go around killing people.
But there are people who have to be killed, Tom.
You're not in combat. The war's over.
Not yet.
Eddie, you're home. There's the law. Now, what'll you tell the police?
The truth.
What's the truth?
You know the truth as well as I do, Tom. Myers turned rat in Korea.
Okay.
He gave away our escape plan, and he got Hennessy killed for it.
But can you be sure it was Myers?
We know it was Myers. We knew, didn't we? Bill.
I guess we did.
All right, tell me this. If we were so sure, why didn't we denounce him 6 months later after we were freed?
Why? You know why, Tom. You were the law student. You said don't denounce.
I said?
You said. We had no hard evidence. A smart defense lawyer could get him acquitted at a court-martial. That's what you said.
All I said was I wished we had more evidence.
You said we would have to get Myers by ourselves. That's what you said. We would find him, kill him, and announce it to the whole world. And that's what we swore we would do. Do you remember, Bill?
I remember.
Tom.
All right, Eddie. All right. But that was a long time ago.
That doesn't mean it didn't happen.
No, but it means it happened in another time, in another place, under different rules.
In other words, you're not willing to do it.
I can't do it. I'm an attorney, a member of the bar. I simply cannot be an accessory to a felony.
Okay. Bill, what's your excuse?
I'm not aware that I need an excuse.
I spent my life looking for Bobby Joe so that justice could be done.
Eddie, we can only have justice through the law.
Okay. Tell me then. Will the law give us justice?
We have no evidence.
Okay. No justice from the law then. Tell me. In that case, where and to whom can we go for justice? Well. Does your silence mean there isn't gonna be any justice?
Eddie.
Eddie what? Hennessy saved the lives of each of us more times than we can count. If it weren't for him, none of us would be around today. He was betrayed. He was murdered because of Robert Joseph Myers. Now, is that gonna be the end of it?
Eddie, there are certain realities that...
I know what you think, Tom. Bill, I wanna hear you say something.
I wish I knew what to say.
Yeah.
You've got nothing to lose, Eddie.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what it comes down to, doesn't it? I'm just Crazy Eddie, the piano player. You guys. Pillars of the community. Rich, respectable. Gutless. Well, I'll do it alone.
Eddie, there must be another way out of this.
Tell me about it.
Look, I don't want him to go unpunished either. But Eddie... Eddie, what's wrong?
Sorry about the dogs.
I don't know. Hey, Eddie, get me a drink of water.
Tom, hold on, or he's gonna pass out.
Let him sleep.
What's the matter with him, Doctor?
Well, I'd say this man's been living on his nerves for a long, long time.
What can we do for him?
Let him sleep. For a week, if you can. And whatever you do, see that nothing excites him.
I'm afraid that's going to be difficult.
Why?
Oh, it's a long story.
He needs rest. Needs calm. Call me tomorrow.
Yes, yes, Doctor.
Bill.
Try to get some sleep, Eddie.
I feel so tired. I'll just rest a while, okay?
Sure.
I never felt so tired, except when we were in Korea, Aaron. Remember?
Yep.
Remember, Hennessy would keep us awake while we were on guard.
Sure.
You were his favorite.
Oh, he didn't play favorites.
He liked you more than the rest of us because... You were the best soldier.
The best soldier tends to have the hardest time living a normal life.
I don't care about Tom, but you, especially you have to help me kill Myers.
Eddie, you need your sleep.
Yeah. I'll sleep a little, and then when I feel stronger, we'll go get him. You have to help me, Bill. After all, if it weren't for you,
if it weren't for me, what, Eddie? Eddie?
What, did he die before he could kill the guy?
Sergeant. Sergeant Hennessy, get me out of here.
Hennessy, help me. Please, don't leave me alone.
You.
I'm sorry. I was having a nightmare. Oh,
darling, look, you just can't keep torturing yourself.
Liz, what am I going to do?
It'll be all right.
No, Liz, whatever I do, it won't be all right. It won't.
Oh, surely you just can't. Didn't that say anymore?
Why did Eddie have to show up now?
Darling, what are you going to do?
I don't know. But I just can't go and kill Myers. It would be throwing away my whole life. Yours as well. Liz, please help me.
I can't help you.
Yep.
No one can help you.
It's all set. We have the closing tomorrow. You'll own a factory, Bill, my friend.
Yeah.
Is Eddie better?
Yeah. He's sitting up now, getting an appetite. In a couple of days, the doctor says he can be out of bed.
You know what we have to do, don't you? We have to get word to Myers somehow. I don't like this any more than you do, but we have to warn him to keep out of sight for a while.
I suppose.
Has he told you where Myers is living?
No. He won't even tell me what name Myers is using.
Why?
I don't think he trusts us, Tom. He thinks we betrayed him and Hennessy.
Bill.
Look, Tom, what's the use? In a sense, we have betrayed Hennessy.
I know.
We've even betrayed ourselves.
It's all part of what you have to do to live. Now, we must find out where Myers is.
Eddie won't tell me.
He might tell me. I'll get it out of him somehow. We'll save him yet, in spite of himself.
Ooh, that's a horrible noise.
Ooh. Oh, I'm freezing. It's so cold. So cold.
Bill, darling, you're having a bad dream.
What?
Wake up.
Can
Wake
we build
up.
A fire? Why won't they let us build a fire?
Bill!
A fire.
Bill, please.
Why can't
Wake
they let
up.
Us have a fire?
Bill.
Eddie.
Yes,
Eddie.
We gotta break out of here tomorrow night. Hennessy said to tell you.
We won't have a chance. We better not.
We'll die if we stay here, Tom.
He's right, Tom.
You guys know where we have to meet?
Yeah, Tom and I know.
Did you tell Myers?
No.
Why not? Myers isn't going.
Why not?
Shut up,
Bill. You can't tell who's around.
Hennessy says Myers can't cut it.
But he's one of us. We can't leave him here.
Hennessy says we can't take a chance on him.
No.
No what?
Without Hennessy and us around to protect him, he'll die here. I'm gonna talk to Hennessy. I'll convince him. I'll convince Hennessy that we have got to take Myers. I'll convince him.
Bill, wake up. Darling, you're dreaming again.
What? Yeah.
Bill, are you all right?
Yeah, I'm all right. Oh. Only sometimes I don't know which is the dream. This or Korea.
Hi, darling.
Oh, hello, Bill. Tom's here.
Oh?
Yeah, he's inside talking to Eddie.
Yeah, I've got something to say to Eddie, too. Look, I almost forgot you saw the doctor today. Is there anything?
Oh, everything's just fine.
Oh, Liz, this should be the happiest part of my life.
I know, Bill.
I'll be right out. Well, how is everybody?
I want to thank you for everything, Bill.
Oh, it's nothing.
I'm leaving tonight.
Leaving where to?
There's a promise I have to keep.
See if you can talk him out of it, Bill. He won't listen to me. He won't tell me anything either.
I won't try to talk you out of anything, Eddie. I want to go with you.
Bill.
What for? To help me or to stop me?
I don't know. I just feel that I have to face Myers with you. And then... Well, right now, I don't know.
Fellas, if this is the way the conversation is going, I have to leave. I can't be part of what happens.
Well, Eddie, where are we going?
I'll tell you when we get there.
What's the matter? Don't you trust me?
Are you going to try to save him?
I don't know what I'm going to do.
We're in this because you tried to save him the last time, you remember?
Yes, I remember. When are we leaving?
Tonight.
All right, I'll go pack.
You don't need much. Just a toothbrush, a razor, and a revolver.
The decisions have been made. Or have they? Tom stays, Bill goes. But what is it that Bill will do when he faces Myers? Right now, his emotions are...
Help preserve good laws. Help change bad laws. Help make better laws. A public service message of the American Bar Association and your state and local bar associations.
And back to the show.
Many of us spend our lives searching for the truth. But what is the truth? When are we closest to the basic essence of our existence? Is it when we have the experience and wisdom of age, or the fire and idealism of youth? We keep asking, what is the truth? The answer is, each man must find his own truth.
Liz! Liz! Eddie's gone.
Yes, I know.
You know?
Well, I went to his room to see if he was up to having dinner, and he wasn't there.
But I was supposed to go with him.
I know that, too.
How did you know? I didn't tell you.
Darling, you didn't have to tell me.
Well, then how?
I have faith in you, Bill. I have faith that in the end, you will do what's right.
Looks as if I'm not going to do anything with Eddie gone.
Do you really want to find him?
But how? How could I even begin to look?
I know where he went.
You know? How do you know?
Well, while he was sick, I sent his clothes to the cleaners, and in his pocket there was an airline return ticket.
A ticket to where?
Now, look, Bill, I won't tell you unless you take me with you.
Honey, you can't go in your condition.
Bill, we have to do this together.
But it might be dangerous.
You're wasting our time, Bill. We should be getting the next plane for Central City.
Oh, boy, I didn't realize how hungry I was.
Well, we missed dinner last night.
Now, tell me something. How do we find Eddie in a city this size?
Where's the waitress? Oh, miss! Could you bring us the morning paper, please?
How's the paper going to help us?
Well, the paper would carry ads for the night spots where he might have worked.
This guy has a smart wife.
If he found Myers, it would probably be in a bar or a club.
Yes. Thank you, miss.
All right, darling, you go through the ads, so just sit and finish this coffee, mm-hmm. Then I'll start looking for Eddie.
Well, I intend to go with you.
Oh, no. No, you don't. It's miserable out. It's snowy. Now, you stay in the hotel. I can find him.
Bill, we won't find Eddie.
What do you mean?
Look at what it says.
Hmm?
Here in the paper.
Listen.
Yeah. Eddie is dead.
What? Musician found shot to death. Police puzzled by mysterious murder. Body discovered in hotel room. No apparent motive. Eddie dead? How can he be? Only yesterday.
Well, do the police have anything to go on?
No. It says here no leads, no clues. Liz, it had to happen last night. Someone was waiting for him. It has to be Myers.
Well, look, we'd better tell the police.
But Eddie said that's not the name Myers is using. We don't know who he is.
Liz! Bill!
Tom, what are you doing here?
I just got in. I checked the hotels and ran you down.
Then you know.
Yeah, I saw it in the paper. That's why I flew out here.
But Tom...
What?
How could you...
Liz, what is it?
Oh, nothing.
Poor Eddie. You know what this means? We're both in trouble now, you and I.
Why?
It's obvious Myers knew Eddie was after him, so he killed him.
Tom, we have no choice. We have got to find Myers.
While we don't know who he is, he knows who we are. In this big city, who is Myers? He could kill us from ambush and get away with it.
Oh, Bill.
Of course, There's one thing we could do.
Yes?
Call it off.
How?
To take the next plane out of here. That would be our way of telling Myers it's all over.
Oh.
Is that what you want to do?
I'm not saying it's what I want to do. I'm listing our options.
I think we have to find Myers, Tom. This time we can turn him over to justice. It's funny the way it worked out. Eddie had to die so that justice could settle accounts with Myers.
We have to find him first.
All right, we'll try all the music places. Liz, you stay here and stick close to the phones. If either of us gets the lead, we'll be in touch.
For me. I hum it all the time. You know, he says to me, "Hey, Millie, I like that." Now he plays it all the time.
I knew the man who wrote it, Eddie Benson.
Oh, you knew Eddie?
Sure, we were good friends.
It's a shame what happened to him. He was, I don't know, somebody once told me a word. Mercurial. Yeah, he was a mercurial character.
That he was.
A guy like him. Oh, he got a lot of people sore at him. Well, at least he left a pretty tune to remember him by. I just can't get it out of my head.
That's
everybody
sucks.
Loves it. Well, almost everybody. I know one character who didn't.
That's so?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you know, it was Eddie's last night on the job. He was playing the tune. And then this guy, who comes in here all the time, this guy wanted to give him $10. Just to quit playing it.
You're kidding.
No, it's a fact.
Do you know the guy?
Oh, sure. He's a regular. Oh, he hasn't been in lately. Yeah. One thing I gotta say about old R.J. Jackson. He's got a tin ear.
R.J. Jackson. Tell me more about him. Liz, I found him.
How?
I'll tell you later. His name is R.J. Jackson. He has a place out in the country, up in the mountains. I'm going there now.
Oh, Bill.
As soon as Tom checks in with you, tell him to take Route 603 to Mountain Lane. Turn right and go up the hill as far as he can. That's the place.
But, Bill, there's so much snow.
And keep the roads clear up there.
Bill, I must tell you. I know what bothers me about
Liz,
Tom.
I want to get started.
Look, how did Tom know to come to Central City? We didn't tell him where we were going.
He said he read about Eddie in the morning paper.
Yes, but Tom was already in Central City early this morning. How did he get
Charlie,
here?
Are you talking about Tom? Now, I'm sure he...
You really should heed her comments a little bit more.
Hi, Tom. Glad you made it.
Yeah. I guess this is as far as the car can take us. It's that house on the top of the hill.
Yeah.
I think we should have sent the police.
How? Once again, we don't have the evidence.
Then what are we going up there for? To kill him ourselves?
No. I think we can get a confession out of him.
Oh, sure.
Now, look, he's human. He's got a guilty conscience. He'll break down. He has to. Now, come on.
Boy, looks like Korea, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Miles and miles of nothing. You could just sink into the snow. It could just be the end of everything.
That's far enough.
What?
Stay where you are.
Look in the doorway. It's Myers.
Got a rifle.
You're trespassing. Now get out of here, or I'll shoot.
You wouldn't shoot us, Myers.
My name isn't Myers. Now get out of here.
We have to talk with you, RJ. We're coming up.
I'm warning you.
Come on, RJ. You can't get away with it.
Look out! McGraw!
Stay low, Tom. There's a line of trees leading up to the house. We'll work our way in.
Ill, this guy can kill both of us.
I don't think he wants to.
Are you crazy? This is the man who just killed Eddie last night.
Right now, he's scared. Come on.
Head for those trees.
Keep away! Keep away!
We'll try for that stone fence.
Tom!
What?
Put your gun away.
I'm not going to let him pick me off.
He'll show himself in the doorway when he wants to shoot again.
Don't. He's only trying to scare us off.
I see him.
Don't, Tom. Don't.
I got him. I got him. Look. He's on the ground.
Hurry up. Come on. RJ.
Don't kill me. Don't shoot again. Get me a doctor.
You'll get a doctor. But first, we'll get a confession. Now, you sold us out in the prison camp. Confess.
No. No, I didn't tell.
Let him alone. He'll confess later. Let's bring him inside.
No, he'll confess now. And when Eddie Benson found you, you shot him.
No, I didn't.
I reckon.
Then who did?
You.
I'm hurt bad. Get me to a doctor. Bill, you were always a good guy. Help me.
RJ, it was a long time ago. The world's forgotten. I don't even think you could be brought to trial for it. It's just among the three of us. Now, I want you to confess.
I didn't do it.
Next to you.
Honest, I didn't do it.
You did, because you didn't show up. You stayed behind. You told the guard.
No.
What did they give you? Did you have to kill Eddie, too?
I didn't kill anybody.
Yes, you did. We can get the waitress to testify. She'll tell how you saw Eddie in the lounge, how you passed out.
Well, sure, I was scared. Because you guys always thought it was me. But it could have been anybody. You, Tom.
What?
Or you, Bill. Or even Eddie himself.
Let's drag him down to my car and bring him in.
Tom.
Now, please. Haven't I suffered enough?
No, it's not enough.
Tom, how did you know about the waitress? Huh? How did you know about the waitress?
What? You told me.
No, I didn't tell you anything about the waitress. I just left a message for you to meet me here.
Well, I... Well, you must have said something about it to Liz.
But I didn't.
Well, then, how would I know?
How? Because Eddie told you.
Eddie? Why would Eddie
tell
me?
You said you could get it out of him. Did you tell him that I would never help him, but that you would? Is that how you got him to trust you?
Oh, come on. Why would I want to kill Eddie?
Because of that talk we had in my house. Maybe unconsciously, both Eddie and I started to think. Why were we always convinced that RJ was the informer?
Because
you were the first one to accuse him. And who said not to denounce him to the army? You did, Tom. And who said let's hunt him down ourselves? You did. Why? Because you knew it would be impossible. You knew we would settle down in a civilian life and forget it.
Well, you got it wrong.
But you didn't figure on Eddie. You didn't figure one of us would spend his whole
life... Well, you know me.
Everywhere you turn, it's you, Tom. You with all the shrewd answers. Why did you have to kill Eddie?
Because he was starting to talk just like you are. And then he figured it out. And he wanted to kill me. So I had to kill him. It was self-defense.
Tom.
I had to kill him. It was like it used to be. Back in combat. Kill or be killed.
You were the informer.
No, I informed, but I wasn't the informer. I just didn't do what Hennessy ordered. I didn't cover my tracks. That's why they found us.
What did they pay you?
Nothing. I wanted us to get caught.
You wanted it? Why?
Well, Hennessy was wrong. The only time in his life he was wrong. We could never have made it, Bill. All of us would have died in the snow. I was trying to save our lives.
Tom.
I tried to explain it to Hennessy. I tried, but he wouldn't listen. He would only say in that way of his, trust me, kid, it'll be okay. And I keep trying to explain to him. Believe me, I try. Every night for the last 20 years, I try to make him see it, but I can't find him.
He's out there in the snow. And I can't find him.
All right, Tom, we better go back to town.
No, wait here. I'll find him. He can't have gone far. I'll find him. I'll explain why I did it. He'll forgive me. He'll understand.
Stop him,
Bill.
Stop him. Understand. He'll get lost out there. He'll freeze to death.
I can't leave you, RJ. We have to get you to a doctor. We'll come back for Tom.
Nice mess.
Later.
They found Tom Wilson later. Much later. About the time of the spring thaw. The snow, the ice had preserved the final
For a free booklet on toy safety, that's Toys, Washington, D.C.,
nice
20207.
Mess.
This message is brought to you by the U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission.
Dreams. The man does. It's what we call the generation gap. And this is not the distance between parents and children. It is the unbridgeable abyss between what a man is today and what he wanted to be yesterday. But that's because you can only be young once. Something you can do more than once is listen. You can listen again and again to our Mystery Theater Tales. Our cast included Tony Roberts, Mandel Kramer, George Petrie, Bryna Rayburn, and Lon Clark. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale.
Now, what made you do a thing like that?
I couldn't help it. It just came out. We were talking and I told him about what happened to you that night.
Nothing happened to me that night. It was just a mistake.
I fainted. There wasn't any mistake about that.
Fainted? What kind of a word is that? Old ladies faint. Me, I just conked out for a couple of minutes.
Yes, but the reason...
Never mind the reason. You're still trying to tell me I'm nuts? I didn't see that guy in the elevator?
No, I'm not saying that.
Because I did see him. Understand? He was some kind of freak, that's all. Maybe somebody who had a bad accident.
But a man without a mouth. It's so incredible. I mean, how can anyone live without a mouth?
This guy was alive. I seen him.
Yes, and he scared you so much.
Did you cut that out?
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by new sugar-free Diet 7-Up. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.
So, what was your guys' thought on that episode? Fun little mess that he got them in, right? What do you think about the fact that two of them moved on and one held a grudge? I'm almost done with the peas that I'm working on, I think. And since we're done with the episode and I got a few other things to do, I will try to get this done and then we will end it. Actually, we have more peas left than I actually realized I had hiding in here, apparently. I've definitely found the episode interesting. Again, it's one of those things where you might know what you want to do, but I think the one guy was correct with his comment of he doesn't know what he'd do till he gets there, because some stuff like that, you'd think you would know what you would do, but Do you actually know what you do until you're in that situation? You can think of how you would act in multiple situations, but truth is, when that situation arises, are you going to act the way you wish you had? Or is something about it going to change the way you're thinking about it? Or are you going to freeze when you thought you would act? Or vice versa? There's definitely no way you can be 100% sure unless you're in the situation, right? So. Quite a little mess, and obviously, the one guy thinking that they're all gonna die in the cold, can't say he's horrible for what he did, but at the same time, you're held captive. You don't want your captors to find you again. Also, we don't actually know, do we, if their leader, if he was killed because they escaped in the snow, or if he was killed by their captors, do we? They didn't really say how he died, did they? I know they said he died and that it was his fault because he told their plan, which obviously that wasn't what happened, but they didn't really say if he just died because they told their plan because they were found and he was killed by them, or what exactly happened. I mean, I'm guessing he didn't just freeze to death. I'm guessing he was killed by them, but they never really stated that, did they? I mean, there's never really a winner when it comes to people being held captive. You get loose or not, you still have the fact that that happened, right? So. That's one of those ones that are always going to be like, what side of the story do you see as the right side of the story? Definitely was an interesting episode. Especially considering the last episode was more futuristic and this one's kind of more stuck in the past. So far I've enjoyed all of them. I do think that the one before last though was just very, very strange. Hiring somebody to kill them if they threatened to kill each other, and that one was just odd to me. I think that was definitely the weirdest one. That's just like, how does that stuff fall into that? But other than that one, which, I mean, it still was interesting, it's just like, it definitely had me shaking my head the most, like, how'd they get there? And how does it just, like, keep going in that manner? And all the different ways that they could have done stuff differently, and just, like, why was that the way that they did stuff? And why would they have agreed to that deal? Why would, you know, that one was just weird. But anyway, I'm gonna finish these last few peas here off camera, I think. And then hopefully edit a video to upload for you guys. So, again, let me know what you think. And if you haven't commented a number, there's on my community page a post I made asking people for random numbers. It's 1 through 1,400. And you can feel free to comment an episode. I am working in order, so whoever commented first is who I'm listening to first, and then we're working our way to the newest comments. If I have already played your episode, go ahead and comment another number if you would like. If I haven't played your episode yet, at least wait till I get to you before you comment another one for me to listen to. But if I get done with this list of people that commented, I will possibly make a new question asking for new comments, so feel free to make a second comment or wait till I post asking people for new ones. Either way, I'm going in the order that the comment was typed out. So, there we go. I think that is all the peas anyway, and everything I had to say. Hopefully you guys have a nice night or day, and so I'll get the video out soon for you.